What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and today we're gonna go over the DNA of making a viral dance hit and the path that you have to take to blow it up. Now first, understand these viral hit dances are not new. You can date what I deem to be the biggest viral dance of all time, the Electric Slide, back to 1976. As a matter of fact, black people love the Electric Slide so much, they reinvent it every few years just so they got an excuse to do it again.
To the left. Take it back now, y'all.
To the left. And of course, years later, you got dances like the Macarena. Macarena. Soulja Boy Superman.
Crank that soul.
Now what? Me.
Crank that soul.
Now what? Me.
You.
But what's really going to be important in understanding what makes these dances go viral, especially today, is there is one, a combination of artificial and organic at work, and I'll get more into that as it goes. But also, the few things that need to be done is actually very simple, but actually doing it is hard, and you'll see what I mean by that as I go through this as well. So let's start with Silento's Whip Nene, which has racked up 3 billion views on YouTube up to this day. Silento's song was very unique in the fact that it was the first song in a minute that actually took a lot of popular dances that already went viral and put them into one song. When you think about the familiarity, but it was still super simple, all of the dances in combination, that played a huge part. And on top of that, it was a super clean, simple, and kid-friendly song, which actually expanded its demographic potential reach from little kids all the way to the old pop side of the world. In comes the X Factor. So where a lot of those things they did to get things moving were kind of organic, now you talk about Dance On coming into play. Dance On is actually a company with Madonna listed as one of the co-founders. And what they are is essentially a huge network of dancers. But these aren't just any old dancers. These are a wide range of dancers with different styles who have influence on the internet. If you're a fan of dancers, many of them that you watch probably are signed to Dance On. And what they do is take a song that they think has massive potential and they run it through their machine of dancers that suit the actual target market of the actual dance, of course, to maximize exposure and accelerate growth. So in Silento's case, Dance On was able to take the Whip Nene from 17,000 in April of 2015 to 42,000 in May.
Stank!
Do the stanky leg.
Stank, stank!
Do the stanky leg.
Stank!
Do the stanky leg.
Stank, stank!
Now break your legs.
Break them.
Break your legs.
So in 1 month alone, they were on the way to tripling the sales. And what the beauty of this is, when those dancers start to do those dances, people organically copy them. Their influence and whether they pick up on it or not is purely organic based on whether they like the dance and they like the song. The track started to move and they got signed to Capitol Records on May 1st. All this stuff seems to be happening quickly, but there's a reason. You have to, one, get the ball rolling, two, figure out how to accelerate it, but then three, you need to capitalize. There's a lot of conversations we might have on this channel where I'm talking about the beauty of being independent and really promoting independent, but if you have a dance hit, you need to get signed or some legitimate partnership. Why? Because these tracks have a very short window of opportunity. Once they start to bubble, it can hit a white hot streak. It's ultimately going to flame out, definitely not lasting more than a few months. And this means that you need to be with a record label or some legitimate institution already that has these connections that can easily get you on an Ellen show or already knows how to set up a nationwide tour without a hitch. Capitol Records was making sure they capitalized financially through record sales and tours, just financially in general, and then Dance On once again is getting that maximum exposure in a short period of time.
That similar path was taken by Juju on that beat.
The track was posted, it was put out, and then it really started to go viral when Fresh the Clowns started to do a dance for it. I'm pretty sure that they paid for Fresh the Clowns to do the dance. Now, the fact they didn't just do the dance, they created the dance. That was on September 7th of that year. By September 20th, Atlantic Records had reached out to them and set a record deal for them. Once again, I know that was fast, and it's like, whoa, how did this happen? But these record labels are becoming really smart and realizing there's a small window of opportunity. So once they recognize that bubble, they may want to capitalize before the track dies down. Some of you got the money, some of y'all have the resources where if you do come up with a dance craze, you can just pay a lot of these influencers yourself. There's so many dance troupes. I imagine if you can get five of them to do your dance and it's actually a good hot song and the dance is simple and easy for people to learn, you could probably get things moving enough at least for a record label to start peeping you and try to get you signed so they can cap off of you. Once again, that's the game. And quickly, I just want to throw in a few tips to actually making a song and dance that has the potential to go viral. The song, beat, and dance must be simple. If you have the ability to grab a hold of something familiar, that can help it move more quickly as well. Silento used a combination of already old popular dances. Juju on that beat used the Nucky You Buck, one of the most popular beats of my era generation personally. And even the Dougie was a throwback to the popular hip hop artist Dougie Fresh. And then on top of that, realize there are two types of dances. There are those dances that actually need the song. That's like the whole Soulja Boy Superman, all of those dances went exactly with the song. Those kind of dances a lot of times help the song and dance move in unison up in popularity. Then you have dances that can move and live without the song. That's the cooking dance, the Fabo, beef it up. And then lastly, you have those outliers that are not only dance, but visual crazes in themselves, like the mannequin challenge, and then the new version of the Harlem Shake. But hey, those are just few of the key frameworks of that formula, but this video is really for you guys to kind of get an idea of not only how to create, but what it takes. You can't copy the how to create too closely, because trust me, culture moves quickly, and culture is about authenticity. You start to try to copy a lot of the old ones too closely, culture just deems it corny. Because we're fickle like that. Anyway, y'all know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.